Okay, welcome everyone to a special episode of Yoda's Hut. I'm Bill. I go by Yodaman on the boards, and I'm joined for commentary on this special premiere episode of Star Wars Destiny play by Derek, who goes by Quakelane on the boards. Hey, Derek, how's it going?
Doing pretty good.
All right, so some of you may know us from us doing commentary on the Star Wars LCG game. Derek and I have both recently gotten into Destiny, and we thought we'd give it a try doing some commentary on this and trying to hook up the camera. I am on the right in this game playing a team of Bala-Tik, two First Order Stormtroopers, and one Nightsister. And I am playing my good friend Jerry, who is on the left at my house here, also known as Yoda's Hut. He's playing a Luke Skywalker and Elite Admiral Ackbar deck. And basically at this point, we just rolled to choose battlefields, and I think we are using Mime, the Imperial Armory. As we get started, we'll kind of explain some of the gameplay for those of you who are new to this. And just kind of see how this goes again with our premiere episode of Yoda's Hut doing Star Wars Destiny games. So you got any initial thoughts just about the game and what we're about to see here, Derek, as we get going?
The game was I was a little surprised how addicting it was. My initial intention was just to buy like the starters and see if I liked it, but I've spent far more money on it already than I care to admit. I know you guys at this point, the decks you're building, you only had one box worth of boosters that you've built on so far. So some things are obviously better than others, but there's some cards obviously you've only got so many to work with when you're building your two decks.
Yeah.
So, because your minimum decks, your exact deck size has to be 30 cards. A starter comes with 20. So, even if you're using all of those, you only have so many more cards to work with. Yeah. And when you build the decks too, you have to match the colors of the characters you're playing. So, like in your case, you've got all three colors, so you can use any card. With his Ackbar and Luke, he doesn't have a yellow character, so he can't have yellow cards in his deck.
Right. So as you mentioned, I did have copies of each of the Kylo Ren and Rey starter sets. I had one of Rey's set and two of Kylo's set, just the way it worked out at the store where I bought them from, and a whole booster box and about six packs, I think, at this point. So our deck building choices were kind of limited. We just did the best with what we could. So we realized these are certainly not meant to be top tier competitive types of decks based on our limited card pool. One of the things I like about the game is just this constant back and forth action where one person takes an action, then your opponent takes an action, and so on. And there's lots of different actions that people can take. You can activate a character where you basically roll its dice and all the attached upgrades that it has to it into the dice pool. You can discard a card to re-roll any number of dice you have, which helps mitigate the luck damage. You can take an action that's on the card if it says action next to it. You can play a card from your hand that says action. One of the important things is you can claim the battlefield, which lets you do whatever the text is on that card, but that means you forfeit the rest of the actions for that round, and your opponent just gets to take them. And as I think you have just talked about initially before we started, you also can also pass an action and just kind of wait to see what you might want to do based on what your opponent does.
The advantage there, of course, being that, you know, maybe you still have events or stuff you want to play to cancel things that maybe he hasn't rolled yet or whatnot that you can still do if you pass. You can just still jump back in and take actions. But once you claim the battlefield, you're done. You can't do anything else except wait till your opponent is done with the round as well.
Right. One of the things we noticed here is as we got started, so Jerry did play what's called Jedi Robes and hit upgrade on Admiral Ackbar, which lets you put two shields on a character when it's attached the first round. Oops, and there goes my camera. This was a bit of a learning experience here, trying to figure out where to position the camera to try to get the dice in the view and also keep the card. So had to play around with it a little bit, and hopefully if you're watching the video, you can somewhat make out the dice, and we'll try to fill in with what we can tell or see and some of the cards out and on there. So I think we got it set back up here. So he, the Jedi Robes lets you put two shields on a character the first if it's the first round, and one shield if you put a Jedi Robes out after that. So you might I put an infantry grenades on one of the First Order Stormtroopers before I rolled that in, which has some different values on its dice. So
yeah, and that's the thing is you can equip stuff, you know, you pay the resources, attach it to a guy, but typically it's better to do it before you've rolled that unit's dice, because then you can also roll the attachment with it, which is what Jerry did when he rolled Ackbar. He had two dice for him, but he got to roll the Jedi robes with it as well, because he had equipped it right before he had activated Ackbar.
Right, and again, for those of you who are a little bit newer to the game, maybe you're just getting into it and doing that, so when you start with your team, yeah, there are point values on the cards. They're in the lower left corner, which you really can't make out based on where I've got the camera positioned here. And you can take up to 30 points worth of characters. And some unique characters like Admiral Ackbar and Luke Skywalker, for instance, and Bala-Tik, which I have on my side, give you the option to take one or two dice. That if you want to take two dice, it costs you more points, but then you get... You have more dice to start the game with, which certainly can be helpful. I just played a card called Unpredictable there, which lets you re-roll one of your own dice. And it also has the ambush keyword, which lets you then take an additional action rather than the normal back and forth there. It looks like I'm resolving guns from that I have on the infantry grenades and Bala-Tik and paying a resource because of the one on infantry grenades to do three damage to Ackbar. Ackbar had two shields. The way this game works is if you have to use shields to block damage, you can't have more than three shields on any character at any one time, unless the damage is specified as unblockable. So he took the two shields off and then took one more damage on Ackbar.
Yeah, and the reason you were able to do multiple dice there is when you resolve dice for an action, you can do as many of them as you want that have the same icon. So if you have five dice that all show a range damage on them, you could literally use all five of them in one turn.
Right.
To do it. So.
Right, and so he just played another Jedi Robes, which I think cost two there. The cost for event cards and upgrades are in the upper left corner, and because it's still the first turn, he was able to put two shields again on Admiral Ackbar. And I played an enhancement called a support is what it's called, called Backup Muscle, which basically lets you, once per turn, you can exhaust it. That means you turn the card sideways and do an unblockable damage to one of your opponent's units. I'm also paying to put what's called a data pad. That costs one on that First Order Stormtrooper.
Now, Jerry played two of the robes. Did he get, I must have missed it, but did he get resources earlier in the turn from that? Because don't they cost two apiece?
Yes, he did. At one point, he used an Ackbar, and the other Jedi robes both had resources, okay. And he got resources. He also did two melee damage. That's the ones that look like the lightsaber to the Nightsister at one point, and then... he got another one in from, I think Ackbar had a gun.
Yeah. And then you claimed the battlefield at some point there. So right. You have that, which means you got the benefit of that card, and you also get to go first the next turn.
Right. And I think Imperial Armory is the one that lets you play an upgrade from your hand at a cost decreased by one. So that's why I played the data pad.
Yeah, so you get to play it for free because it's a one-cost upgrade. Yeah.
And I'm playing an upgrade called the Holdout Blaster, which has the ambush keyword. That means I could play that card and then take another action from it. So I actually chose to roll in the Nightsister with the Holdout Blaster to get two dice out in the dice pool. And it's a little hard for me to make out what they are there. I know that I think I've got a plus two on the Holdout Blaster, because I can kind of see the blue. I'm not exactly sure what the Nightsister had.
Yeah, the Holdout Blaster is a really good card for its cost. And it's neutral also, I believe. So I think you can play it in a light or dark side deck.
Right.
If I remember correctly.
Right. So when you make your teams up, you can either use heroes or villains. And there are cards in the card pool that are only heroes or only for villains, and also there are some that are neutral that you can play on either side. In addition to the colors that I think we should
those
mention
are
here.
The gray cards are the neutral cards.
Right, you've got gray cards that are neutral. You've got blue, which represents force, red, which represents command or military, yellow, which is sort of rogue or smugglers kind of things. And if you use, you can only use cards of a certain color if you've included a character of that color on your team. So I can actually use every card available to for villains, so either villains and neutrals, with my side. And Jerry can only use blue, red, and gray cards, the neutral ones, on either heroes or neutrals for his side.
Yeah, so he has no yellow cards in his deck.
Right. He has no yellow cards in his deck. At least he shouldn't. I think we have legal decks. Right. He also played an enhancement called Scout on Luke Skywalker there. So he's got a lot of shields out right now.
Yeah, and you keep enhancing units and you get more and more. Another cap that we haven't mentioned is the fact that you're allowed a maximum of 3 enhancements on one unit.
Right.
But you can play additional ones, and even if you're below the maximum, you can essentially replace one that's already there, and you only have to pay the difference in the cost.
Right.
So that's another way to get some of those higher ones. You know, if you've got one that costs 4, for example, if Jerry already had the Jedi robes there, he could remove that and then play it in its place and only pay the difference of 2.
Right.
Which is much easier since you get 2 resources per turn.
Right, right. As you just mentioned, you get 2 resources to start the game, and then basically at the end of the round, after both players are done taking actions, you get what's called the upkeep phase, where each player gets 2 resources and you ready all your characters. So you sort of turn them facing the right way again instead of sideways. And now Jerry just rolled in the Luke Skywalker with the Scout dice. So he's got a lot of dice out there, and you can see some of the symbols there. The things that look like little stormtrooper helmets, as I call them, are the shields. There's sort of something that looks like an explosion, which is disrupt. That lets you remove your opponent's resources. There's something that looks like the little yellow resource tokens that you might see up towards the left on Jerry's side, that lets you gain resources to help pay for stuff. There's things that look like guns, which are called range damage, that do damage to characters. There's things that look like little lightsabers, which are melee damage. There's sort of a little like arrows going around there called focus, and they let you spin however many dice the numbers say to any side that you want other than the one you're already on. And you also sometimes see things that sort of look more like a circle with another little circle inside them. Those are a special symbol, which have different abilities on different cards that let you, you know, if you happen to roll that, you can do it. And almost every card also has the red side that you'll see that's the blank, which does nothing. So it looks like I'm playing unpredictable again there, which is ambush, so I can re-roll a die and then do another action if I want to.
I don't remember. I know you said earlier that it's re-roll one of your die. I might be remembering wrong, but I thought it let you re-roll any die, whether it's yours or your opponent's.
Oh, yeah, that's correct. Sorry.
I might be wrong.
No, you're right. I said that wrong. You can re-roll any die, either yours or your opponent's. I was choosing to re-roll one of mine.
Yeah. Another thing, I don't know if you can tell, but on the red die there that's in front of Luke, it's got the damage on it, but it's also got the little, it's hard to see the kind of little yellow symbol at the base of the die. And that is basically a resource cost. So if you want to resolve that die, you have to pay a resource to do it.
Right.
So a lot of the dice have these various sides, like you say, but some of them have that requirement, and then there are other ones that say that are the coloring is actually blue instead of black, and it'll be a melee, but it'll show like 2 melee with a plus next to it. And what that means is you have to resolve that die with another die that has the base symbol on it. So like if you have a 2+ melee, you would have to have a regular melee and resolve those together. Otherwise, you cannot resolve that plus die.
Right. So so I did at one point resolve, I think, 4 damage on Ackbar. He shielded 2 of it, put something on it, and then Jerry played what was called Field Medic, which lets you cost 1, but you can remove 2 damage from a character. So he took damage off, and then I used the backup muscle support, which let me move a, or what you do is you put 3 damage on that when you put it out, and basically once per turn you can exhaust it, turn it sideways, and move a damage from it to a one of your opponent's characters that's unblockable. So now Ackbar has 2 damage on it. Basically, there's 2 ways to win this game. You either defeat all your characters by, you know, basically damaging them up to destroy them. They have a health capacity up in the upper right-hand corner of the card. So Ackbar has 9 health. Luke has 12. My 3, Nightsister and the 2 First Order Stormtroopers, those 3 have 7 health. And Bala-Tik, the yellow character, has 8 health. Or you, if you can make your opponent run out of cards in both their hand and their deck at the, and if the round ends, you can win that way. So.
Yeah, it's a little harder to do it because there's a side of the die that it lets, makes you discard cards at random as well. But beyond that, once you've drawn your deck, you're never like forced to draw more cards. So as long as you choose not to play the cards in your hand, which is definitely a disadvantage, it's hard to actually win that way unless you've got a deck that's designed with a lot of discard yet. So I haven't, I'm sure it's out there and we'll see it eventually, but there's the mill type deck where you kill your opponent that way is it's a harder way to win, at least at this point.
Right. So so Jerry chose to resolve the 2 what are called focus dice that were on the Jedi robes. He changed the Luke Skywalker die to just melee damage, which I think is a 3. I think he changed it to a 3. And they changed one of the Admiral Ackbar dies to a 1 resource is what it looks like.
Yeah.
And
that's the thing with like somebody like Luke. You were talking about the difference in points there. Right. I think your screen is not as focused as well.
Yeah, I think it'll come back in a second. That's probably my camera just got out of focus for a second.
Yeah. And you were talking about the point values for placing guys. I mean, some of them, like for example, you're building a 30-point group of guys here. Luke, for example, is, I think, 15 points for 1 die.
Right.
But for 5 more points, you get a 2nd die. And though Luke has, you know, 2 really strong ability strikes, plus he has a special. So he's a really good character. And he has another ability as well. Whenever you get to draw a card whenever he's activated to strike, or whenever you roll his dice, basically.
Right.
So the trick is figuring out when you get the how to do the 30 points. And it's like, is it worth it to get – maybe this guy's not that great, but for 3 or 4 points, I can get another dice. It's not that bad a trade-off.
Right. Yeah, if I would have had 2 Lukes, obviously I think – we would have built the Luke Ackbar deck the other direction, that you can play 2 Luke's dies for 20 points and 1 Ackbar for 10, but I have 2 Ackbars and only 1 Luke. Now, at one point I played, I think, the card called He Doesn't Like You, which lets you remove one of your dice to remove one of your opponent's dice. That means you put them back on their cards before they can resolve them, and I moved the datapad die back to put that 3 melee that Jerry had back on his card, so I wouldn't get hit with that damage. Since my Nightsister has 4 damage on her already, she's getting close to
the being knocked out of here. Close to dead. She has a really useful ability. At any time, it doesn't cost you, like, you don't have to roll a special to trigger it or anything. She just has a built-in action that you can do 1 damage to her to re-roll. I believe it's any die on the table. I think.
Right. That's
so. Yeah, that's real good for getting rid of something like that. There's also, you know, I've had times where someone's got like 3 dice out there and there's a 1 range and then 2 dice that say 2+ range. So that's 5 damage. But if you get rid of that 1, they can't resolve the other 2 because they have to have that basic 1 to go with the pluses.
Right, right.
So, yeah, there's a lot of manipulating your dice as well as your opponent's dice to accomplish whatever you're trying to do.
So it looks like Jerry is actually claiming the battlefield here, and again, that's Imperial Armory Battlefield, which lets you put an upgrade into play for cheaper. He's not actually doing it, and I discarded something to re-roll, and I got the Infantry Grenade Special, and I can't tell again if I got a gun on the Nightsister, if I got that something else.
I don't know.
The infantry grenades, what that does is it does two damage to each characters, and then you have to discard the infantry grenades if you hit the special. So I get rid of two of Luke's shields and got a couple more damage on Ackbar. And then I think that was a disrupt I must have had on the Nightsister, because I see Jerry got rid of his resource, and then the other one I couldn't do anything with.
Right, it was a modified like I said, guy. It had that. It was a 2+ gun, so you can't resolve it without having another gun to go with it.
Yeah, so I still have one resource sitting there, and each time you start a new round, you draw up to 5 cards unless you don't have enough in your deck to do that. And if you claim the battlefield and have control of it, which is on your side of the table right now, Jerry has that, then that means you get to actually go first in the next round, which is usually to your advantage, that you can get stuff out and try to resolve stuff before your opponent can maybe have a way to disrupt your plans here.
Yeah, well, it's, for example, there's ways to use dice. Some dice have a special abilities to remove other dice. For example, if you roll first and get your dice on the table, your opponent doesn't have a way to deal with it unless they've got some type of card in their hand,
right,
to do it. So, and since also with that round ending there, you had one resource left over, so now you should be at 3. So now you could play something that's more expensive, or have more, you know, more options for multiple cards and such. Because Jerry's got his standard 2 this turn.
Yeah, and so. So Jerry just rolled in Ackbar with all his stuff. He's got a couple blanks, and he's got the focus on Ackbar, and I think that is a discard. That's another one of the sides on a dice that you can get. I think he's got a 1 discard on Ackbar.
Yeah,
showing.
And the discard things are annoying because when you force your opponent to discard a card, it's at random.
So I am playing a lightsaber on the Nightsister there.
Yeah, that costs 3. And that one also has redeploy, which is another keyword that means if that character dies, normally you discard everything that's attached to him, but if it has redeploy on it, you can just send it to any one of your other guys.
Right.
And
there are... Go ahead.
I was
gonna say, there are some cards that, again, those of you are newer to the game or just getting into it, that you can only play on certain color characters to start with, or you need to have a certain color character on the board to be able to play it. For instance, Jedi Robes, I think, says what's called spot a blue character, which means you have to have a blue character alive on your team, and then you can put it on any of your characters, whether they're blue or not. But some cards actually say blue character only or red character only. But I think that, if I remember right, the redeploy aspect gets around that, you know, you can redeploy around restrictions.
I don't know if it does, but actually right now I don't think there's a card in the game that has redeploy that has any play restrictions.
Right.
To my knowledge. So I don't know how that works, if that's... true or not.
Right, that's true. I guess the lightsaber actually doesn't say you have to put it on a blue character or anything like that.
It has no requirements whatsoever.
Right.
It's really nasty because not only does it have a couple good sides to the dice for damage, but it has a special also that if you roll it and when you trigger it, you can deal 2 unblockable damage to any unit. So it's a third side of the die that has at least 2 damage, but it actually can get past shields if your opponent has shields on their character.
Right. So I guess the Ackbar thing was actually on 2 focus, not 1. So he just changed all of the dice, the Jedi Robes dice, to resources. So he must have something big he wants to try to do or play here, I guess.
He's got nothing super valuable to do this turn, and he's just playing for the future.
Maybe
he's got a couple expensive cards or something.
I think I just played the card called Squad Tactics, which lets you activate all of your non-unique characters at once, and I have 3 of them there. So
yeah,
a bunch of dice I was just able to get out, and I got to put them back in the right place.
That's a quick way to roll all your guys. It saves you actions so you can get other stuff done and get all your dice out there quickly.
And look at all those blanks I just rolled. Now, I see there's the lightsaber has the special. I can't tell what the holdout blaster was. I kind of put it up too far on the screen. I got it out of the line of the camera. And he's taken 2 resources there.
Yeah, there's some crazy events that you can make use if you time them right. One of my favorite ones that I've used in a couple tournaments I've played, I can't think of the name of it, but it's a one-cost dark side event that you spot, you know, how many dice your opponent has rolled blanks on, and then you get to remove that many dice.
Right, and they don't
they don't have to be that one exactly. So like in that case where he had the four dice, he had the two blanks and the focus and the discard, you could have literally say, I spot these two blanks, I'm going to discard your other two dice.
Right. So I
did that twice in a tournament yesterday where I spotted three blanks and removed three others.
Right. So I was able I used the lightsaber to do two unblockable damage to Ackbar because I had the special on there. And then I just, I think I'm doing the random discard from the Nightsister, and I got rid of All In, which is another one of those ones that can break timing. It lets you resolve all your dice, no matter what faces they're showing, in any order you want. It looks like he put Force Throw, I think, on Luke.
That is a very good card.
Yes, it is. I'm glad he did not roll that. And I'm going to roll out Bala-Tik here, and I've got yet another blank. Now, one of the interesting things about redeploy cards is it's good to try a time. My Nightsister's only got three health left. If you actually redeploy the upgrade and the die is still on the card, or in this case, I resolved it and put it back on the card, and you put it on a character you haven't rolled yet, then you get to roll it in again. So you can really try a time.
No, Yeah, even whether you've used the die or not, if it's on the card or off the card, if you use redeploy, I think it comes back onto the card.
Right, it does.
Even if you've rolled it and you got a blank and you move it, you'll be able to roll it again.
Right. Now, I just put both of those cards on the First Order Stormtrooper, and that was probably a bit of a mistake. This is one of the first games that Jerry and I had actually played. We probably maybe had played two or three games at this point, just trying like the starter stuff, so we're trying to get used to the cards and what you could do. I probably would have been better off putting one of those on Bala-Tik, because his ability is after an opponent's character is defeated, that you get enough damage to kill him, then he readies again. So if I had put them on Bala-Tik and somehow have a way to kill Ackbar, I could have potentially rolled those dice back into the card pool.
Well, and there's no advantage to having them on the trooper over Bala-Tik. In fact, Bala-Tik has one extra health.
Right.
But yeah, eventually you're probably going to get to Ackbar. So they would have been better off being placed on him versus the trooper.
Right. As I said, this is Jerry and I showing our noobness here, that we were definitely like just learning the game, trying to get into it. So we, at this point, we might
the game's about a month old. I don't think there's too many non-noobs there, if there is such a thing yet.
Yeah, well, I know some people have been playing this on the tabletop simulator that you could get on Steam probably for months, probably since, you know, at least 3 or 4 months. So they've gotten a lot more games in,
I haven't used that.
So Jerry resolved the special on Scout, which what that does is you look at your opponent's hand and you discard the card that has the smallest cost. And if it's a tie, you just get to pick. I did another 2 damage, it looks like, to Ackbar there.
Yeah.
With the trooper. And I've only got one card in my hand left to try to re-roll stuff now.
Yeah, which is the flamethrower, which is great early. Well, not great, but it's definitely more useful if your opponent has more units. So given that Ackbar is about dead, you're probably not going to get much use out of it. It does have one side of the die that has 4 damage on it that's really good, but besides that, it's not too exciting. And its special is deal 1 damage to every enemy unit. But when there's only 2 of them out there and one's about gone, that's kind of irrelevant at this point.
So Jerry actually made me discard the jetpack before, or whatever it was, before I could use their flamethrower.
It was a flamethrower.
And Ackbar's ability is after your opponent plays or discards the last card from their hand, he has to choose to do 2 damage to a character. So I actually put the 2 on Bala-Tik, and then I resolved one of the shield dice to give a shield to Bala-Tik.
Yeah. And now you got nothing but blank dice out there, and there's nothing you can do with them.
Right, and I don't know if he claimed or, oh, he's going to roll. So he's re-rolling and got the special enforcer, which really won't do much because what that does is, with all my blanks, and I'm going to use backup muscle to kill Ackbar there.
Yep, because that's his ninth damage.
And now so let's see if I realize I could ready Bala-Tik or if I'll forget. As I said, I think this is the first time I tried Bala-Tik, so I probably wasn't sure of exactly what he could do. It helps to read the cards and figure out. Oh, yeah, I am writing him.
And had you put those weapons on him, you'd be able to reroll all three of them, those dice now. As is, you're just going to get to reroll Bala-Tik.
Yeah, live and learn. So I guess, like I said, Jerry's Forcer, it's a really good thing if you hit the special. What you can do is you can remove one of your opponents, or actually any dice. It could be one of your own if you needed to, and then do damage to a character that I think you're supposed to equal to the value of it. So,
and it doesn't matter what it is. You could remove a two-shield die. It doesn't have to be like a range or a melee.
Right, exactly. So... A four
you could
shield
even
die.
Use it to. You could even use it to remove a special. Specials are considered a zero, but typically they're pretty nasty abilities. Right. So, the force throw is really powerful.
Right. So Jerry is playing the lightsaber on in place of Scout.
Yeah, to reduce its cost.
Right, and I think he claimed. So I rolled Bala-Tik and got one of the focus sides, so I can focus that Stormtrooper. Has a two damage side on it, so I would think I'm going to do that and then resolve the two damage on Luke. So I'll get rid of the shield at least, and he'll get one damage on him. So he is down to just Luke. I've got three characters left with quite a bit of health there, although Luke's still got 11 health. He's a pretty beefy character.
And he's got two decent weapons or enhancements on him as well right now.
Right.
Upgrades, I guess they're technically called. So, but you've got, most of your guys are basically full health, with the exception of Bala-Tik, but he has a shield on him, so.
Right.
He needs a big roll, and he needs to get at least one of those guys off the table really soon.
Right. And he certainly could do it with the cards that he has on Luke.
Yeah, and the thing is, too, most cards they've got, if they got a special... It's on one side of the die. Typically, that force throw has it on two sides.
Yeah, that's rare.
Yeah, so that's what makes it super good. I think it's got one of the side of it is a decent amount of damage as well. Although I can't remember off the top of my head what it is. But he what I if I'm in his place, he's adding Ray's staff.
Okay.
The special on Ray's staff is you remove that die to remove an opponent's range or melee damage.
Yeah, I think that's correct.
But what he needs to do is get rid of one of your guys. Personally, I would go for the guy in the middle, just because he doesn't have redeploy on the notepad.
Right.
And it's going to take the same amount of hits to kill him as it is to kill Bala-Tik at
this
point.
So I rolled Bala-Tik and. Yeah. That didn't help me. I got a big old blank there. And it doesn't look like Jared got a bunch of stuff either. It looks like he's got some shields or resource in a blank.
Yeah, he rolls like I do.
I do like that all the time. On the few games I've played on Tabletop Simulator, I feel like I roll blanks on there all the time. Especially with Stormtroopers that have two blanks on their dice.
Yeah, that's the downside to having... blanks. Although there is a card out there, I think it might be neutral, or it might be only villain. But it's a two cost event, and it says change all your dice that you've rolled blanks on to any side you want.
Oh, right.
And that is quite useful in a deck that has a lot of blanks.
Yes.
Or if you just roll like I do.
I'm not sure what I played there, but I put one of his dice back. It might have been... I'm not sure what it was.
I don't know.
Yeah, I couldn't see what I played. But whatever I did, it looks like I spent a resource to do... Whatever it was to put a die back.
Put Luke's die back, yeah.
Probably because that's the more threatening one.
It's the scariest one, yeah. That force throw is a close second, but Luke's die has the three melee on it.
Right. So he resolved Ray's staff and took a resource. And it looks like I'm going to. I think I played. Am I playing squad tactics again? Because it looks like I'm rolling them all in.
Yes, sending the group.
And look at those blanks again.
Wow.
Did I pay for that? I need to pay for that. I wonder if I forgot to pay for that.
Maybe that's why you roll blanks.
Maybe. Hopefully
I
we'll
see
catch
one
that.
gun. I can't remember. I can't make out what's on the lightsaber. I see a one gun on the blaster, I think.
Yeah. And it looks like maybe a resource on the Stormtrooper. So he is playing deflect, so that's probably gonna get. So he's gonna put
Def
the
deflect is really good.
right, so deflect lets you basically put a it's a range damage. You can send half of the damage rounded up back to another unit, so he sent it to Bala-Tik and got rid of the shield.
Yep.
And then I just used backup muscle to put a second damage on Luke.
Haven't you? Is that the end of backup muscle? I think
Yeah,
you've
that's it.
worn it out.
Yeah.
Okay.
So,
Yeah. See, that's the one nice thing about this game. You can have these rolls like this, but you discard one card and you can re-roll as many of those as you want.
yeah, I really like that aspect that it helps make you at least feel like you're mitigating the luck factor and randomness of the dice, that you have ways to do it, or just other dice manipulation cards and techniques
Yeah, a couple things we
matches.
didn't mention at the very beginning of the game. The initial mulligan rule is really forgiving in this. You draw five cards, keep whatever you want, put the rest back into your deck, shuffle it, and draw back up to five. So, really easy to get a decent starting hand.
Yeah, so I think I'm not sure what if I was discarding there and trying to figure out to roll or if I'm playing something. That must have been
You
something
must have
that
played that event that said remove a die to remove a die in the
yeah, I
game.
guess so.
Because you pulled your data pad out of there.
Right. Well, that seems like a good use of that blank. Get rid of the four-star die.
Yeah, all he's got is a shield now sitting on that lightsaber, I think.
Yeah.
I think that's a shield.
Yep, and he is putting a shield on there.
Yep.
And I am taking a resource.
Yeah, see the thing is you've got too many guys with dice out there. You've got six dice to throw. He's got four right now, but he's maxed out. He can't put any more enhancements on there. He can replace ones and upgrade, but he's not going to ever get any more dice unless he plays some support out to the side that has dice with it. So, and you can keep adding dice to it, and that's really where he's at a disadvantage here. He needs to get off the table. And that's why I said, like, I know he's done a couple damage to Bala-Tik here. I would have gone for the Stormtrooper just to get rid of that data pad.
All right, so I just rolled there and got that looks like a pretty decent roll. I got
I see
Bala-Tik's
the
focus and I got the lightsaber, I think, is the 3-for-1.
Okay, I couldn't see it. Yeah,
Yeah.
then you can change the Stormtrooper to whatever you
To
want.
a 2. Yep. So I'll do 3-for-1 to Luke. That's gonna he's the shield, he'll have 4 damage on him, and then I'll get 2 more with the Stormtrooper. So Luke's gonna have 6 damage on him now.
Yeah, he's halfway there.
Yep. And then nothing else I can do. Backup muscle, I guess, just stays out on the field, even though it has
Yeah, it doesn't
nothing
go
on there.
away. Well, it just becomes useless.
I wonder if maybe I had an extra resource before and it was just off the side of the screen since I
Oh,
kept th
maybe.
think I did that.
Well, you still have three resources
Well, I just
now,
took 2 more.
Sean.
Yeah, well, I meant maybe that's why it looked like I hadn't paid for something, but it might have just been sitting
Yeah, who
off too
knows?
far because I know a couple times when we've been watching this, it's felt like it. Now, Jerry's going to get to roll first again here, so if he can get a big roll, he might be able to get rid of Bala-Tik or one of these Stormtroopers or something.
Oh, he would need
Bala-Tik's reaction
six
doesn't do anything
damage.
now, so.
Yeah, Bala-Tik is useless at this point. He's just a die. And
Right.
he doesn't have any particular like super great sides on it
Now the
on
focus has
any
been the
weapon.
most useful.
Yeah, the biggest damage he's got is a 2+ on the gun.
Yeah, so Jerry played field medic. So he got to heal 2 damage off of Luke, so Luke's back down to 4. But that should be the only thing left in his deck like that. Looks like
Yeah.
I got a shield and a couple guns, a couple range damage between the trooper and the holdout blaster.
Yeah, you just need to accumulate your guns and go to work on Luke here.
Yep. Sounds like a plan.
Yeah.
And maybe Jerry has some cards to give himself shields or another deflect would be good. Card?
I don't know if it's in your deck, but you've got three resources. I'm always afraid of the reversal event. It's
right.
A three-cost yellow card. But it's just like Deflect, where it sends damage. It removes a die and sends the damage back at a unit, except
right.
that it's the full value of the dice, not half rounded up, and it can be used on melee or range.
Right, right. So Jerry just rolled in. He's got some specials there. He's got Ray's staff. He's got Luke's lightsaber special, it looks like.
So the lightsaber is a straight two damage.
Oh, I think he got the force choke or force throw special, too.
Yeah, the force throw, he's going to get rid of your highest value die.
I think all mine are ones.
Yeah, well, maybe he waits. And see if you decide to re-roll anything here.
Yeah, I'm probably trying to think, is there any way I can get rid of one of these dice? So I think I'm going to resolve some range damage while I can. So
yep.
I think I'm going to do two to Luke. He's going to shield one. And now he's got a bunch of specials there. I got a looks like I have got at least a resource, and I got a blank on the trooper, and I think... Is that another resource? I can't tell if it's the resource or the shield on the Stormtrooper.
I saw
I
the power,
it must
the
be the
power
res-
of the dark or power of the dark side in your hand. That would be a good support to play,
especially
with that deck with all the blanks in it.
Right. What that does is if you roll a blank, you do two you re-roll a die, and if you do roll a blank, you do two unblockable damage. So he used the Forcer to send my lightsaber back and do a damage to Bala-Tik, who I haven't even rolled in yet.
Yeah, and that's good because that way you're not going to re-roll that lightsaber.
Right. Luke's saber, he can do two unblockable damage to something, which I assume would be Bala-Tik. And Ray's staff actually doesn't do him any good right now. He might be better off saving it.
Yeah, this is a case where he might pass instead of claim the battlefield, just in case you re-roll something that he can use it to remove.
Right, so it's important to point out, again, one of these Destiny rules is, while most of the time you'd want to resolve all the dice that show the same side, this is a case where, because the one special doesn't really do anything right now, Jerry's probably better off leaving Ray's die out there to either remove some range damage if he needs to, or even just re-roll it if it turns out that it's not going to come into play, rather than because it wouldn't really do anything at this point.
Mm-hmm. Did he heal Luke? I thought Luke had six damage.
Yeah,
on.
He used the field medic again. Right,
oh,
it was
okay.
One of the first things he did. It actually may have been the first thing he did, if I remember right.
All right. So what does he got? He's got, is that a shield on the Luke die?
Yeah, I think he's got a shield on Luke's die and Ray's staff, which lets you remove that die to remove a melee or range damage dice.
He's got a resource, too. He might just re-roll both dice and hope he can get enough to kill Bala-Tik.
Yeah.
He needs three damage. Ray, there's damage on... oh, that's good.
So that
changes.
Is... Use the force, right? Yeah.
Yeah, spot a blue character to change a blue die to any side you want. So he turned it to the three melee, which is enough to kill Bala-Tik.
And I use Bala-Tik's focus to do change the Stormtrooper.
Yeah, get use out of him before he gets killed.
Well,
maybe not.
Looks like we're backing up for
Unless
a second.
You go.
I am playing Cannon Fodder. I changed my mono what my action be. And what that does is it lets you basically take the damage somewhere else. So I'm going to take the three damage from Luke and put it on that First Order Stormtrooper with a data pad.
Yep.
So Bala-Tik will live. So I changed my
mind. I'd have put it on the other Stormtrooper. He's got the redeploy weapons. So
yeah,
that's the
I don't
guy
know.
You want to die.
Yeah, I don't know why I did that. Again, early games. Like I said, we probably played four or five games at this point.
Yep.
This is one of the first ones we got on camera where the camera was set up right. We did try a couple other games on camera, but I got to get so close to the dice and you couldn't see what cards we had, so I redid.
Right.
So I'm re-rolling everything here. And I got a 2-for-1 with the trooper and a +2 with Bala-Tik.
Yeah, see, here's the case where now he can remove that one, and now you can't trigger the other one.
Right, I can't trigger the other one, but I can re-roll it if I want to.
Yeah.
Looks like I'm trying to decide, do I want to play Power of the Dark Side? I've got enough resources, I might as well.
Yeah.
Yep. So I'm going to play Power of the Dark Side, and I would bet Jerry will end up claiming, probably, just so he can...
Yeah, here's the case where actually the best thing you could roll now with Bala-Tik is a blank.
Yep, exactly.
Because he's got the 2+, which he can't use. He's got one gun, I think one shield, one resource.
Right.
And I can't make out what the last...
He's got the focus on him.
Probably a discard.
He's got a focus.
Oh, it's a focus?
Yeah, because okay. I've used it a bunch of times. I kept rolling it.
Oh, yeah, that's right. So, yeah, the only thing, I mean, you could use a resource or the one damage, but I think you'd rather just do 2 damage.
What is that? Disarm? Oh, that's the card that lets you remove a die showing some type of damage and then discarding an enhancement or an upgrade that costs the same or lower. So I got rid of Ray's staff there with...
Yeah,
that.
You basically blew up Ray's staff with that 2+.
Right.
He actually did have a use for it.
Yeah, the lightsaber and force throw cost 3, so I couldn't use that. So we're drawing up now, and Jerry had claimed, so he's going to go first again here. So now, I used cannon fodder to save that trooper, but you know now he's got more damage out. He's still got 7 health left on Luke. I've got what 2 on or 3 on Bala-Tik left. 4 on the stormtrooper, so that's 7, and then the other trooper's got full 7 health. So I think I'm still in a decent position here. If I could just roll some stuff.
He needs to get something off the board just to eliminate. If he were to get rid of that damaged stormtrooper and Bala-Tik, he's not in. I mean, one on one against that other trooper is not a bad matchup. Right now. Looks like you got another Ray staff.
Oh, maybe it doesn't discard it. It might just put it back in their hand.
No, I thought it... I'm pretty sure it discards it.
Okay. Well, I know there's one of those cards that just returns it to their hand, so they'd have to play it again, but...
Yeah. Disarm, I think, is the one that destroys it.
I am honestly not sure.
Huh. You got your special with the lightsaber again.
Yeah. And then he got specials with the lightsaber on force throw. Luke looks like it's a resource or something. It's either a resource or shield and a blank on Ray's staff.
I hate rolling that stuff with the Luke die just because the other sides of it are just so much better.
Yeah. So I probably want to use that pay for the holdout blaster, which I think is 2-for-1 right now, to get the 2 damage on Luke. Before he would throw it back at me.
Yeah.
Unless I've got a trick here to roll more dice and resolve, but I don't think I probably do. I'm spending one. I think that's flank.
Flank, yeah.
And my stupid cat won the way, so I think I'm using flank to move the forcer to die back, yeah.
Yeah, flank is really good. You can only play it if you have more ready units than your opponent does, but it just removes the die.
Yeah.
It's really good.
Yeah, I think that was a pretty good play there.
Yeah. Yeah, you got to get rid of that.
Yeah. Yeah, that's one of those cards that I've noticed as I've, you know, played more games since this of so he's resolving Luke's lightsaber special does 2 unblockable to Bala-Tik there.
Yeah, he's one away.
Yeah, he's in trouble. Is that flank's good to put in when you have one of these, a deck like this that has 4 characters or 3 characters even. So I'm resolving that, doing 2 damage to Luke. I think I accidentally put it on the trooper instead of the holdout blaster.
Yeah, flank is not great in a deck where you've only got two guys, but if you have three or four, it's pretty decent.
Yeah, it's worth putting at least one in there, I think, because you can kind of count on being able to use it at certain times. It's a lot trickier if you've got two.
Now, here's the nice situation where that Power of the Dark Side, you've got a blank on a Stormtrooper die there that has two sides of it are blank. So yeah. Rerolling that one likely gets you two more damage on Luke.
All right, so he got Ray's Staff Special and a blank on Luke. So I'm going to resolve the Lightsaber Special, which will do two damage to Luke.
Mm-hmm.
So Luke's got 9 damage on him, so I'm making progress here.
I think you need to roll Bala-Tik while you can. He's only got 1 health. If he re-rolls and gets anything.
You got to focus there.
Well, he could turn Ray's staff to damage.
Yeah, so I'm going to roll Bala-Tik now. And, whoops, I don't know where it went. Looks like I got a gun.
Well, that could potentially be enough if Power of the Dark Side triggers... with your Stormtrooper die, you
got... Oh, he's going to use Ray's die to move Bala-Tik's die back.
Yeah.
Well, I would think use Power of the Dark Side. Either use Power of the Dark Side now, or just roll the other Trooper in.
Yeah, you still got a Trooper you haven't used yet.
Yeah. And I got a 2-for-1 on the Trooper. That's pretty good. I can do 2 more damage to Luke.
Mm-hmm.
I've got a resource.
Yeah, all he's got is a focus, which is useless with it being the only die out there.
Yeah, I think he's discarding and rolling it again.
Yep.
And he got, is that a resource, I think? Or is it a shield?
I think it's a shield.
Yeah, I think he got a shield.
Yeah, he might just have to use that.
Yep, I'm spending the 1 and doing 2 to Luke, so now Luke's 1 away. And I think he'll give Luke the shield.
Yeah, and now I think you use Power of the Dark Side.
Yep, use Power of the Dark Side, and I can re-roll the Trooper. Got a bunch of cards to even keep re-rolling if I need to.
Well, the Trooper has the 2 blanks.
I re-rolled both of them there. I just discard. Maybe I was hoping to get something with the data pad.
You can probably just win with Power because he's got guns on 2 sides of his dice, and he's got blank on the other 2. So as long as you roll any of that... with Power of the Dark Side, you should win.
Well, I guess what I'm probably thinking is I need to get the blanks or the 2-for-1, the 2 or the 2-for-1, but I also need to make sure I have a resource if I get the 2-for-1. I think that's why I re-rolled the data pad. Yeah, and I got another blank, and that'll do it, because that'll do 2 unblockable to Luke, and my Trooper will take him out.
Mm-hmm.
Only... First Order Stormtroopers are so precise.
he never did get to Bala-Tik.
No, he didn't. So I'm going to win that game despite a few misplays there that it probably would have been better off redeploying differently and maybe doing a couple other different things. But, again, that's how you learn the game. You got to play it some, and this is again one of the first games that we have played. But it's definitely a fun game, and it's interesting to do commentary on it, but hopefully people are watching here. Anybody's tuned in to see us or, kind of give us a pass here that this is our first attempt at this, and hopefully it wasn't too bad, and we'll should get better as we start doing some more games with this. So you got any comments about this? I didn't actually go over deck lists just because there's so much involved, but I'll make sure I post the deck lists up on the final video probably at the beginning of the game, so rather than talking them out.
Yeah, there's just too much. We can't list off every card and every deck, but by the time we do it, the game will be over.
Right.
it's a fun little game. I mean, we're not going to go into explaining the rules of the game in future episodes. It's just because this is kind of the first go-around at it, so a lot of people might be new to this. We're not going to have to explain the base rules, but... the game itself, there's a lot more strategy, like I said, than you initially think. So, it's more fun than I gave it credit for when I initially saw it.
Yeah.
So,
And I really didn't get into it till basically when the cards came out, I finally started looking at them, although I didn't pre-order cards, so it's one of the reasons why I was sort of lacking in the deck options that we had there, that I didn't buy cards right away, and it was a little hard to find product. I've got a few more cards now, and I'm working on building things up, but it's definitely got me intrigued. I love the back and forth. I love that it kind of moves quickly, all the little tactical decisions, and just try to figure out the best way to approach things. So so I want to thank everybody out there who's watched us and given us a chance here. If you haven't watched Yoda's Hut before, as I said, we do a lot of LCG games that we've done for about the past year, Derek and myself, and we're branching out into Destiny, and hopefully we will try to continue bringing you more content, and we'll kind of get into more of a routine of how to do the commentary for these games as well too. So as always, thanks for joining me for commentary, Derek. I appreciate it. And
anytime.
Yep, we'll do it again soon.
All right.